She's the subject of a Hollywood biopic and is very much alive. But the White House has been in contact with Senate Republicans about possible replacements for the ailing 85-year-old Supreme Court justice. The White House is even working on a short list of possible nominees to replace Ginsburg, who broke her 25-year streak when she began missing oral arguments on Monday. The White House counsel's office is even trading names with the office of new Senate Judiciary Committee Chairman Lindsey Graham. Politico published a list of them Thursday. The short list of potential replacements for the ailing Ginsburg includes Seventh Circuit Judge Amy Coney Barrett, whose name got floated before Trump nominated Brett Kavanaugh. Others identified include Joan Larson of the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals, Raymond Kethledge of the Sixth Circuit, Britt Grant of the 11th Circuit, and Thomas Hardiman of the 3rd Circuit, who served with Trump's sister, Marianne Trump Barry. The White House is taking the temperature on possible shortlist candidates, reaching out to key stakeholders, and just making sure that people are informed on the process, a source told the publication. Graham is still putting his stamp on the judiciary panel. He met with Trump's Attorney General pick William Barr this week, even as some Democrats complained they couldn't get FaceTime with the nominee. He said he got assurances from Barr that he wouldn't shut down the Mueller probe. Ginsburg continues to recover after doctors removed two cancerous growths from her left lung December 21. Until Monday, she hadn't missed oral arguments. She was confirmed to join the court after Bill Clinton's nomination of her in 1993. Following her initial in November that resulted in fractured ribs, Ginsburg declared herself almost repaired, and immediately got back to an exercise routine. "Glad to see you are feeling great," President Trump told her at an event for the late Justice Antonin Scalia. But in initial comments he also brought up a grudge. "I wish her well. She said something very inappropriate during the campaign, but she apologized for it," he, the president, said in November. "I wouldn't say she's exactly on my side, but I wish her well, I hope she gets better, and I hope she serves on the Supreme Court for many years." In December, following her cancer surgery, Trump tweeted, wishing Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg a